Jesus, Messiah. He is the name above all names. And as the song says, He is our hope, our rescue, our ransom, and our Redeemer.
For so long, God's people were bound to a law they could not obey. In fact, the law became a curse to them as a set of rules that called for perfection. Perfection they could never achieve. They wanted to be reconciled to the Holy God, but their sin stood between them and their Creator.
It was required that a blood offering be made to cleanse one from sin and to be made right with the Father. And so finally, God sent His Son, Jesus. He would become sin and would give Himself to be sacrificed for all sin, for all time. This one is our Redeemer. That's how it happened. His lifeblood flowed away on a cross at a place called Calvary. And even while he was dying, he asked his Father to forgive those who were killing him.
But that cry for forgiveness was for us too. We were in bondage to our sin, but he gave himself as a ransom, a payment for our freedom from darkness, shame, fear, and dread.
So join us then as we sing these great hymns of assurance and commitment to Jesus, our ransom.
Into thy freedom glad. Each time I think by the blood of Christ I am redeemed. He paid my debt, the ransom for my sin. Even now I can hardly take it in. Oh,
thank you, Jesus, for your love. Love enough to free us from a place of hopelessness, a place that we had created for ourselves.
Thank you for the grace that has given us a fresh start, a whole new life, something that we do not deserve, nor could we ever earn.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for showing us that we were lost and that through you we can be saved.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Your grace is much bigger than our sin.
If you could see what I once was, if you could go with me back to where I started from, then I made me what I am.
Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Again, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
The early church used those words as a greeting whenever they saw one another. But it was not just a greeting. It was a statement of fact. Jesus, who had died, been buried for 3 days, he was alive.
On that Sunday morning, we now call Easter, the tomb where Jesus was buried was empty. The stone had been rolled away, and his grave clothes were left behind. And then he appeared, alive, first to his followers, and once to over 500 people.
It's true. It did happen. Ascended into heaven to be at the right hand of his Father, where he is still today, mediating for us at the throne of God. Because Christ's blood has covered our sin, he can say before judgment is passed upon us,
not guilty. That one is mine. Not guilty.
So what does his death mean? And what does his resurrection mean? Why does it matter? Only you can decide that.
He died for your sin and rose for your eternal reward. But how that translates into your daily life is up to you. Not by your strength or your will, but by your surrender.
It's not possible to fully comprehend how it all happens. I just know that it does.